what we've got behind us is the reconstruction that we use for the TWA 800 investigation. What hits you is the enormity of the accident, the number of individuals that were involved in helping us do what we did here, but also reminds you, I think, what we're doing and who we're doing it for. You know, we're certainly doing it for the families that were affected here. We're certainly doing it for to make sure no other families have to go through this again. So I don't worry we're going to lose that feeling and that purpose once this is decommissioned.
When we brought this here in 2003, prior to that, there was a conversation with the family group, and they were very clear that they would support it for training purposes, but did not want it to become something of a museum piece or where people just sort of casually walked by and looked at it. If it served a purpose to improve safety and transportation and to teach, they were fully on board with that. And so they were now more a central focus in the response to the disaster. And this accident really was that turning point.
But along the way, we never have found evidence, and this is corroborated by the FBI. We have never found evidence of anything that shows evidence of a higher energy, a higher order explosion you would get from a bomb or a missile, nor did we see any indications on the structure of pre-existing damage, which we would call fatigue or corrosion. We'll keep looking for it, but we're also looking more strongly at the possibility of a center wing tank explosion simply from the explosive nature of the vapors in the center wing tank. All we needed at that point, in a way, was a spark. And so we learned a lot, but it took time, and our recommendations followed along those paths too. So those are two big takeaways from this investigation: targeting and mitigating the risk from flammability, but also trying to minimize any risk of wiring and shorts that could ever enter this tank.